Hey, AT from CNC at home. I'm going to do another tile. This is the two paint kind of version. I painted some tiles orange, fluorescent orange, and a fluorescent lime greenish color. And then I painted black on top of that. So the intent here is to cut away the black, leaving the green or the orange behind. And so the first test we're going to do our good friend, the Hulk. All right, let's start a new project in light burn. We're gonna do the Hulk as a tile. So what I usually do when I'm doing tiles is I bring in my template. I'll bring that in here. It's 108 millimeters square, because that's the size of the burning area of the tile. And then we'll bring our image in. So I'll just bring my image of the Hulk in. And he's way too big. So up here we're locked. It doesn't really matter, I'll just do it off the center here, and I will change him down to 110. And the reason I do 110 is that gives me a 1 millimeter border larger than the tile, so that I make sure that I'm burning completely edge to edge on the tile and a little bit past, and I don't have to have it super accurate when I do that. So we'll hit enter. I did have this locked, so we're at 110 millimeters each direction. So if I bring this down, it should snap. I don't know if you see that. It just snaps center to center when I get that close. Let me just adjust this template, put it on top so you can see that layer. Now let's do this. Oops. You can see that we're just outside, the image is just outside the size of my tile. The other settings that I need to do when for this, we need to get our burn parameters set up. Gotta grab the right thing here, or image that we want. Okay. So on our image, what I wanna do is I wanna burn this as an inversed image, because I want the lighter spots to be green, and so I need that to be burned away, and the dark spots need to be black. I need to leave that alone. So that's opposite of what normally would happen. That's why we choose inverse image. We'll also change these parameters a little bit here, but we'll start with 3000 millimeters per minute and 50% power. Okay, we're going to use 90 degree scan. We're going to use Jarvis. So that all looks correct. So we'll click OK. And we can press Alt P to get our preview. We can also come up here and click on that little screen that gives us our preview. Let's just full screen that. Okay. Now, this is odd. This is a different invert. This only inverts what we see here, so that should be turned off. So this is what's going to get sent to the laser. All of this dark area, everything that's black or dark, that's where the laser is going to be burning. Everything that's white is not going to burn, and because we're doing a black tile or black painted tile, then that will actually be black. So what actually ends up happening is backwards of what we see. So that's kind of something you have to get your head wrapped around a little bit. So that's what we're going to send. That's all that we need to do. This particular image is got good contrast and should work well for this project.
So you may have seen this on some other channels. I'm copying this totally, but I have a friend of mine who's kind of into the Hulk, and if this turns out, this will make a nice tile for him. We've got the laser converted over to doing tiles. Let's take a quick look. The last thing I had done with the laser was using the rotary roller, so I had to take it back down to its normal position, get my waste board on here, and we'll get it focused up with a tile here in just a moment. Might help if we connected that x-axis back up. Oops. Let's get that hooked up. There we go. With my daughter giving us some background music on her violin, let's just get some of this ash washed off. So when the laser burns that paint, it leaves just kind of a slight grayish film on there. You'll notice that when I scrub this, that green really starts to pop out. I'm just using a Scotch-Brite pad and rubbing very gently over the paint to get that cleared. Once the tile is dry, I want to get a clear polyurethane coat on there. I'm using a water-based spray polyurethane to do this. I'll just put a couple coats on each of the tiles, and that should protect the paint. Here's the Hulk picture that we started with, and then what the tile looks like. Let's put those side by side so you can see the image and the tile. That really turned out nicely. I did some other tiles. I did one of the sun using the orange background. And I did one of our favorite frog, Kermit. That one turned out pretty nicely too. The conclusion here is that painting the tile one color and then putting black on top and burning the black away is a viable and good process.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.